paralyzes me. You knew I was going to walk in strength and be able to battle. The devil be reminding me. But if I stay stable, knowing that the world will work its perfect thing in me, I ain't got nothing to worry about. That's where my strength come in Christ. That's where my strength comes. That's where my stabilization comes from. Him! I've been trusting in me way too long. It's time for me to lean on Him. And ever since I've been learning, I've been blessed. Can I get any real here? I got so to the point that people don't want to have nothing to do with me. I mean, they don't want, they see me coming, they just see nothing but the devil. I'm talking about Christians. You know, sinners wanted to see me because I had some money. I'm talking about my brothers in Christ. Amen? But, the Lord said, when are we going to stop acting like this? I said, well, look, he said, you're ready to go to hell, aren't you? I said, what you talking about, bro? He said, first of all, you didn't love your wife. And I told you to love your wife as Christ loved the church. And if you don't begin to love your wife, you're going to have to learn how to love me more to love her. And he said, if you don't learn how to love me more, you're going to go to hell. I said, okay, Lord. And I walked and I began to love God more and love Christ more. It hurt to love Christ more. So y'all think it was easy. It wasn't easy for me because I was too prideful. The only one I loved was me. And see, God had to make sure he talked to me because the only voice I would listen to when I hear God was my own, because I'm the only one I would ever listen to. Well, y'all ain't hearing me. But anyway, I said, okay, Lord. And I'm standing in the program, and I finally turned it over. My wife wanted to leave me, divorce me, and everything. But I didn't want to worry about what she said. Amen? There's a scripture that pastor taught years ago, because this is the only unmarried man that can teach on marriage by anybody I know. So I said, where's that at? Numbers 30, verses 10 through. I went through there and said, to make everything the woman says utterly void on the day that you hear it. So no matter what she said, God is looking to see what I'm going to say. So I said, Lord, divorce ain't going to come out my mouth no more. Lord, separation ain't going to come out my mouth no more. And I'm standing on it. That's what we in my house. We don't serve the Lord. A house divided cannot stand. I love my wife today. I'm not going to let the enemy come in. Devil, get away from my family. Get away from my wife. And I'm standing there, and she came in the program, and she walked past me that she didn't recognize me so much. Now, here's a woman I've been with for 24 years. She didn't recognize me. She walked way past me. Wow, she was looking for a familiar spirit. But today, God is restoring it all. Why? Because of what I stood on. I said it ain't going to happen. Amen? Today, God is restoring it all. Every single bit. Everything that the canker worm grows out of it, and caterpillar wanted to eat up, God is restoring every bit of it. Every single bit of it. And a lot of it has to do with one key thing. I started listening to my wife. I started listening to my wife. And in listening, I fell in love with my wife. She's the greatest gift God has ever given to me. Amen? I love her. I love her. Amen? Well, I'm going to get me choked up here. 2 Corinthians now, chapter 6. Familiar scripture. Starting at verse 14. Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship has righteousness with unrighteousness? And what communion has light with darkness? And what concord? What agreement? That word concord means agreement. What concord has Christ with what? The devil. Christ ain't got with the devil. What have got with the devil? No agreement at all. Or what part has he that believeth with an infidel? And what agreement has the temple of God with idols? For you are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Amen? Let's keep going. Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, said the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and you will abide, and will be a father unto you, and you shall be my sons, and you shall be my sons and daughters, said the Lord Almighty. Amen? But you got to have a made-up mind. You got to have a made-up heart. Amen? And for my closing scripture, I'm going to go to Ecclesiastes, chapter 12. Hope y'all got something out of this tonight. Amen? Ecclesiastes chapter 12. I love this too. I stand on this scripture too. Starting at verse 13. Ecclesiastes 12:13. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God. Keep His commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. For God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. One more verse. Amen. Zephaniah. This is my name. Zephaniah. ZEP. Amen. There you go. Right there. All right. This is the scripture that the Lord gave me, woke me up in the middle of the night. And I hope it can bless you. I read it in the morning. I read it in the evening. I put it in my spirit whenever I start thinking negative. Or whenever I even think about going back, because the devil likes to play those recorders up in your head. That's why I love when Dad was talking about we need to start telling ourselves what to think. And these are one of the things that I use to tell myself what to think. Because the Lord tells me what to think. Amen? Starting at verse 17. The Lord thy God is in the midst of thee, is mighty. He will save. He will rejoice over thee with joy. He will rest in his love. He will joy over you with singing. I will gather them that are sorrowful from the solemn assembly, who are of thee, to whom the reproach of it was a burden. Behold, at that time I will undo all that afflict you, and I will save you that what has, and gather them that what was driven out, and I will give them praise and fame in every land where they have been put to shame. Hallelujah. And at that time I will bring you again, even in the time that I gathered you, for I will make you a name and a praise among all the people of the earth when I turn back your captivity before your eyes, said the Lord. Thank you, Father. Father, I just thank you right now. Thank you for the night, Lord God. I just turn it all over to you, Father. I pray that this was a blessing. I pray that your word will move and touch the heart, that they are willing to hearken with an intent to change, that they will now become sons and not children, that they will be obedient to this church and be obedient to the visionary of this church, so that they may fulfill their vision and purpose in you, Lord God. I just thank you for the day, Father. I just praise you for the day, Father, because the day you will be changing our captivity before ours. We have no reason to be shameful anymore. We have no reason to walk with our hands down, but keep our hands up in the name of you, Lord God. We just thank you because you keep us covered each and every day. And we'll be careful to give you the praise and the glory always. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, brothers.